Belhaven, North Carolina is right down the road from Washington, North Carolina. It's not local, though. Let's call the operator and find out what is.
Can you tell me what other exchanges I can call locally from here?
Sydney Cross Road and Pint Road.
And what are the prefixes there?
964 and 935.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
This is a Carolina telephone step with older tones, apparently generated by two separate tone plants, because the ring is of the type that is generated by subdividing the 60 Hz power frequency, while the low tone is of the type generated by a rotating machine. Now, having dialed zero from so many step offices across the country, I couldn't help but notice an unusual click on this particular office, which I'll point out here. The tick I'm talking about is not that click, but that one. More about what that is later on. Let's dial a local ringing number. When you pick up a payphone in this and many other Carolina telephone steps, you hear a tone which is quite loud until the dial tone comes on. Very often that tone is louder than the dial tone itself. Only the coin phones do this, and Farmville, which we visit later, has a high-pitched tone before the dial tone comes on. In every case, this pre-dial tone tone, which only payphones have, is the same tone as is heard by the operator when she answers, the tone that tells her that you're calling from a coin phone. Now, Washington did not have a pre-dial tone tone on its payphones, and that suggests that there may be more than one scheme being employed to class mark the payphones for the operator. Speaking of segregating payphones from the operator and long distance, here's an attempt to dial one first from Belhaven. This being a payphone, it isn't allowed. You dial one and you go into the camera trunk. And shortly after the camatrunk soups to get the number, you get dumped to a reorder. Something's wrong with that interrupter. It messes up a couple of the impulses on a regular 6-second repeating pattern. What that suggests is that the reorder may be tied to the same interrupter as is making and breaking the ring, because the ring is on a 6-second cycle as well. At this point, if I had two phone lines, I would call a ring on one and a reorder on the other and listen to them at the same time and see if they synced up, and of course if they did, it would mean that the ring and the reorder interruption were on the same camshaft, in spite of the fact that the tones are being generated by different sources. Someone in the UK, by the way, has done this. They called a ring on one line, reorder on the other, listened to them at the same time, and noticed that they did sync up. and then decided to make a piece of music out of it. Telephone and Rubber Band by the Penguin Cafe Orchestra. To do that, they needed two phone lines, but here in Belhaven, North Carolina, we can do that with just one phone line by using the callback circuit. The callback circuit, again, is the device that is used to ring other parties on your line or make your own phone ring. You dial a code followed by the phone number. If you eliminate some of the digits in the prefix that are normally absorbed, you can get the number ringing early. Then you keep dialing and you superimpose a reorder over the ring, and by doing that little trick, we can actually get the ring and the reorder together on one phone line, and that will make it easy to see if they sync up. And I wouldn't be surprised if they don't, just because the ring doesn't sound like it's coming from the same source. Then again, the ring interruption might be in sync with the reorder interruption. I just have to know. Let's find out. What do you know, they are in sync. The missing impulses always occur around the end of the ring. Okay, now let's try calling one of the two local prefixes, Sydney Crossroads 964. Here's a busy signal and a vacant number. After getting the busy, I flashed to reset the trunk, and then redialed only three digits and went to a vacant number recording. Why didn't I have to dial four digits? Because this office selects the line on three digits, and then the fourth digit only selects the type of ring that will be used. But this isn't a step. This is, well, the next call will give a hint as to what type of office this is.
The number you have dialed is not in use at this time. If you need assistance, please hang up and dial your operator. This is recording in Sydney. The number you have dialed is not in use at this time. If you need assistance, please hang up and dial your operator. This is recording in Sydney. The number you have dialed is not in use at this time. If you need assistance, please hang up and dial your operator.
Well, now we know that voice. That's the Tri-County Telephone Membership Corp guy, famous for Pinetown.
This is a recording in Pinetown, North Carolina.
This, again, is one of those all-relay switches, which features two recordings. Must be standard issue. In the background of the recording, you could hear a dialing noise that sounded very much like what you might hear in a step office.
If you need assistance, please hang up and dial your operator. If you need assistance, please hang up and dial your operator.
But you really only heard the rotary dialing part, in other words, relays following a subscriber's dial. You don't hear any selector cut-in noises.
If you need assistance, please hang up and dial your operator.
Here's a ringing number in Sydney. That was a wire trunk, which when we first went into it had a 2600 Hz tone on it for some reason. The tone is unrelated to the operation of the trunk and seems to be associated with the equipment in the CO being ready to receive the first digit. That it's 2600 is probably a coincidence. And now, try finding Sydney Crossroads, North Carolina on a map. Good luck! It's very hard to find even any sign of it. When I was there, I wanted to go record this rather interesting sounding exchange, of course, and I remember that I couldn't find a payphone, but the biggest challenge was finding the town. I think I found where the town was supposed to be, but in the end, the only exchange of this phone company I was able to record was Pinetown. So, while you're fruitlessly trying to find Sydney or Sydney Crossroads, North Carolina on the internet, let's do two more Belhaven local things. First, that famous broken reorder on a blocked level, then a busy. Belhaven, from which we're dialing, does have a local vacant level recording. The trunks are arranged so that if you interrupt the recording with dialing, it will go back to ringing. The reason for that is that the recording is set up to play once and stop, and if you were to hit the vacant level and continue dialing a complete 7-digit phone number, you'd miss the recording. So they reset it and give you a chance to stop dialing so that you can hear it the one time that it plays. Let's do this a little more interestingly and call the vacant level through the callback circuit. First, I'll dial the code for the callback circuit, then something that goes to the vacant level. At that point, you'll hear the ring of the vacant level trunk and the recording will start up. Then I will continue filling the callback circuit with digits. As soon as I do that, of course, the vacant level trunk will go back to ringing. And then when I finally get through dialing, the callback circuit will superimpose the reorder. And around that time, the recording will have gotten round to the beginning, and we'll hear the callback circuit's reorder on top of the recording.
We're sorry. You have reached a number that has been disconnected or no longer in service. We're sorry. You have reached a number that has been disconnected or no longer in service. If you feel you have reached this recording in error, please check the number or try your call again.
"943" is the prefix here. 964 is Sydney. The other local prefix is 935, Pike Road.
The number you have reached is not in service at this time. If you need assistance, please hang up and dial your operator. This is recording by Croak. The number you have reached is not in service at this time. If you need assistance, please hang up and dial your operator. This is recording by Croak.
Yes, it's Mr. Tri-County Telephone again, and this is another all-relay system. I didn't get two recordings. There may have been a second one, but I didn't find it. But I did get two different sounding rings. Pike Road appears to be like most all-relay systems I've encountered, in that the second-to-last digit selects the line, and the last digit only selects the type of ring that you're going to ring with. In other words, each phone line has 10 phone numbers. Pinetown may be an exception to this. Here are two calls to Pike Road, one to a single ring, one to a double, but these also are two different ring power frequencies. You know, it's clear that Pike Road has many ring power frequencies and both single and double ring. I should have sat there and recorded all 10 possibilities, but this was actually my first experience with an all-relay system on the ground. Didn't know much about them at this time. So anyway, let's move on to the way of calling directory assistance from Belhaven, which is to dial in that Carolina telephone style, 82411.
Do you have a number for the time of day?
We don't have a number for time, sir.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Now, if you listen carefully to that call, you can see that the 8 goes to another location because that's when you can hear the T-carrier noise coming on. Let's try dialing just 8 plus 411 and see what happens.
reporting an error. Please check the number or try your call again.
I know that recording. That's the one from Washington. So looks like 8 is going to the Washington, North Carolina building, at least. So 8 plus 411 didn't work. Let's try 8211. Well, they've really made it so you have to dial 82411. You can't skip any digits. Why not just 8411? Clearly 8 is enough to select the trunk to Washington. Why does it have to be 82? Well, you know, I didn't know this at the time, but in reviewing the tape, it became apparent why they've done it this way. Here's a tape of dialing 8 and then 1. Notice that when I dial the 1, that click that we heard back at the beginning when we dialed 0 is heard, but then the trunk doesn't work properly. There's that same tick, but while waiting for the operator to answer, there's no audible ringtone. And now that she has answered, my polarity is reversed, so my payphone won't let me talk.
May I help you?
Because it thinks that I'm making a local call and I need to put in 20 cents. Now, why would they have an alternate code, 81, to reach the operator? Well, the answer is that there isn't any code, 81. It's just that if you dial 1 on the 8 trunk, you do end up reaching the operator, and then it doesn't quite work right. Customers are never supposed to dial 81. What they're supposed to dial is 82, and then the service codes 411 or 611 or even 811 for the business office, as it turns out. The 8 goes to Washington. The 2 tells Washington that this is a service code call, and the reason the 2 has to be there is because this very same trunk group that you get on 8 is also used for dialing 0. They've combined the 2 functions onto one trunk group. The 1 tells Washington that this is an operator call. Now, customers just dial 0, and then something in the originating trunk circuit flashes the 1, and you can tell that that's going on, because when we pick up a phone here and dial 0, you hear, and that's the equipment in Washington responding to a 1 being sent. Now, as far as Washington is concerned, there's no difference between our dialing 0 and our dialing 81. But at this end, there is a difference, because when you come into it on 8, the Belhaven office doesn't apply local ring. Good thing it doesn't, otherwise it would be on the whole time while you were talking to directory assistance. And of course, on 0, it has to flash the trunk and then not allow the polarity reversal to get back to the phone so that we can talk to her from a payphone. So, I've just wasted a tremendous amount of time explaining a mystery that only I sort of half wondered about back in 1977, but at least it's solved. All right, now let's try some other things beginning with 8. For example, here is 825. This is obviously for internal use, and they don't make the telephone company employees dial that silly 1-1 at the end. It's just 825, and that's enough. Now here's 82611, followed by 827.
Reporting.
believe I got that on 87 while I was in Washington, and that was in the middle of the night and it didn't answer, so now we know what that is. How about 82 plus 811?
Hello?
That went off hook, and from the payphone I couldn't talk to her. Probably a mistake on their part. It would be awfully mean to have someone calling in to re-establish their phone service that had been disconnected for non-payment, and then they can't even talk to the business office lady. Besides, if that were done on purpose, the lady, instead of saying hello repeatedly, would have said, "Oh, you're calling from a payphone. Show me the money and we'll do business with you." So I'm sure it was an innocent mistake. Here's 829. You know, in all the time I've spent in Carolina telephone territory, I've never heard operator intercept except on cryptic codes such as that one. In Greenville, North Carolina's NX1, the code 110 went to operator intercept.
May I have the number you dialed?
752-2000.
Let me check that, please. That's showing a working number, sir. Would you please try it again?
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Now, possibly they have set it up so that in those rare cases where a number is changed and you really need a referral, it goes to a call diverter type device, which picks up a phone line and dials 829 on a Belhaven line or 110 on a Greenville line. And as crazy as that idea sounds, sister company United Telephone of Florida actually did that. This is a long-distance call from New York City to Fort Myers.
Please remain on the line and an operator will assist you. The number you have dialed has been changed. This is a recording. Please remain on the line and an operator will assist you. The number you have dialed has been changed. This is a recording.
Now what comes next is the sound of a call going through on an NX1 phone line after something's been dialed on it.
Special operator, what number you dialing?
332-4311.
332-4311?
Yes.
Number was changed to Cape Coral, 549-1121, sir.
549-1121?
1121.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It may be a crazy idea, but United Telephone doesn't think so. And this is United Telephone. And speaking of NX1s and long-distance calls, the next stop will be another visit to Greenville, North Carolina, where there is an NX1 that is a toll center, and I'll be dialing various long-distance calls from someone's home phone.